Google just released a new accessibility app called Reading Mode, which helps make long-form content more accessible. You can change the format of the text, or you can listen to it. Let's talk about it. Hi everyone, it's Carrie from Carrie on Accessibility, and I talk about technology and accessibility. If you're interested in that type of content, hit the subscribe button and the bell so you don't miss another video. So Reading Mode is Google's version of things like Voice Aloud Reader, Speechify, Speech Central, all those different apps that take an article and make it so you can listen to it. But with Reading Mode, you're able to use an accessibility gesture or button with it. And it's definitely more integrated into Android, even though it's a separate app. So today I'm going to show you on my Pixel 7 Pro how to get it installed and set up and how to use it. So first you want to open your Play Store and look for Reading Mode, and you want to make sure that it says Reading Mode
Google LLC.
By Google LLC. And then you want to double tap on install.
Open Reading Mode, Reading Mode.
Once it's installed, you can go ahead and open it.
Uninstall. Image of app or game, open. Reading Mode. Welcome to Reading Mode.
And we're going to go through the tutorial.
Reading Mode turns long content from apps or websites into a format that's easier to read. Continue.
And then we're going to select continue.
Set up a shortcut for Reading Mode.
Just swipe to the right.
To get started, 1. Go to Settings. 2. Turn on the shortcut. 3. Tap Reading Mode shortcut to choose whether you want to tap a button, use a gesture, or hold volume keys.
Okay.
Then, when you're reading an app or website, you can open Reading Mode with a shortcut.
And then we're going to swipe to the right again, and we're going to double tap on Settings.
Accessibility.
Once you get here, you want to scroll down until you get to Reading Mode.
Action button map, link to window, Reading Mode, screen, Reading Mode,
Reading Mode. And you want to go into there.
Reading Mode, Reading Mode shortcut, off.
And you want to
shortcut settings.
Turn on this toggle. So I'm going to double tap on that toggle.
Off. Allow Reading Mode to have full control of your device. Full control is appropriate for apps that help you with accessibility needs, but not for most apps.
So we're going to scroll through this.
Allow.
And I'm going to double tap on allow.
Use gesture to open. To use this feature, swipe up from the bottom of the screen with 3 fingers.
Okay.
Got it.
And I'm going to double tap on got it.
Reading mode.
So for me, I have the accessibility gesture enabled, and you can actually change that in your settings. By default, you should have an accessibility button, and this is a floating button that's always on your screen, and I don't particularly like floating buttons. They're not very accessible for me, so I go with the accessibility gesture. If you swipe to the left from the toggle,
Reading Mode shortcut, accessibility gesture.
You can double tap on this.
Reading Mode shortcut.
Checked. And
use accessibility gesture. Swipe up from the bottom of the screen with 3 fingers.
And if you don't want to use the button or the gesture, you can also long press the volume up and down.
Not checked. Hold volume keys. Press and hold both volume keys.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and cancel. If you want to switch from the accessibility button to the accessibility gesture or vice versa, you want to be in the accessibility menu, scroll all the way down to the bottom.
Text to speech. Accessibility shortcuts.
And the second to the last item should be accessibility shortcuts. Double tap in there.
Accessibility button and gesture. Quickly access accessibility features.
And you want to double tap on that first list item.
Accessibility button and gesture. Quickly access Use button or gesture. Gesture.
And right here, you can double tap and select button if you want to. So if you have TalkBack on, it's a 3-finger swipe up from the bottom. But if you don't have TalkBack on, it's just a 2-finger swipe up from the bottom. Also, another thing is if you have 3-button navigation with the home, back, and recent apps at the bottom of your screen, you can have a button all the way to the right with like a little accessibility button on your navigation bar, and this will be what launches Reading Mode or accessibility shortcuts in general. It is a little bit different on Samsung. You'll still have to go to your accessibility settings, and then there is an option there for installed apps, and you want to double tap on that, find Reading Mode, and it's a similar process from there. Once you have all that set up, you want to go back to Reading Mode. So I'm just going to back out.
Settings. Reading Mode. Finish.
Okay, and now I can double tap on finish.
Play Store. Navigate up.
Now we're going to go ahead and find an article and test this out. So here I have TechCrunch's article about reading mode, which is a really short article.
Visually impaired people read long form content.
So from here, you can do the reading mode. The only problem is that currently TalkBack has a problem where if you swipe up with three fingers from the bottom, it also brings up screen search, which is hopefully a bug that they'll be able to fix. And you can kind of go around this by either using the accessibility button that I talked about earlier, or you can assign a specific customized gesture with TalkBack for the accessibility shortcut. And for me, I have that set to four finger triple tap. That might be a really complicated gesture for some users, and you can go to TalkBack settings and completely customize it and pick whatever gesture you want to use. So I'm gonna do that.
Reading mode. Hide reading mode. Close. Okay. Pop-up window. Reading mode makes long content easier to navigate, read, and listen to.
The first time that you use reading mode, there's going to be a little tutorial and you can just listen to it. If you swipe to the right, it says selected. And this just kind of tells you how many pages there are in the tutorial, which is not the most helpful TalkBack feedback, but that's okay. Just keep going.
Next.
And there's a next button. Hopefully Google can improve this.
Pop-up window. Tap play to hear content read aloud.
Okay. And then we're going to swipe selected through that until we get next to next and double tap.
Pop-up window. Adjust font, color, spacing, audio preferences, and more.
Okay, we're going to
selected
keep done going until we can double tap on done.
Reading mode. Hide reading mode. Close.
And from there, the first thing is hide reading mode. So if you want to exit out of it, you can.
2 minutes read.
It'll tell you how long it would take to read using the audio player.
Settings.
And so right away on the screen, you have the article in a very simplified format. There's no buttons, no links, no pictures, no advertisements, nothing like that. And I feel like this could help people who are visually impaired, dyslexic, or just people in general that don't want to read all those advertisements. And so we have a very simple UI here. There's a settings button at the very bottom, and right in the middle, there's a pause and play. And on the very right bottom corner, there is font where you can increase or decrease. So we'll just test out the play button first.
Play.
And I'm going to double tap on that.
Pause. Pop-up window.
Oh, there's tap a to skip pop-up to the next window.
Sentence. Touch it. Got it.
Okay, we're just going to double tap.
Reading mode.
Tap settings on there.
Chrome. Close tab.
Okay, be quiet, TalkBack.
Visually impaired people read long-form content, TechCrunch. Along with its Android update for December, Google has launched a new app called Reading Mode.
Pause.
Okay, we're going to pause that. Unfortunately, as of now, we cannot do the two-finger double tap. It doesn't control the reading mode, but hopefully Google will be able to fix that in the future. Another thing is that there's a skip back and skip forward that only shows up when it's playing, which is just a little bit cumbersome for both somebody who is visually impaired and somebody who uses TalkBack. It's like just confusing. I think that it's a pretty nice voice, so I'm gonna go ahead and play it, and it does pause the audio playing while TalkBack is talking, which is a really good implementation. So I'm gonna double tap there. And
skip back.
There's a skip back,
skip forward,
forward speed. And there's a reading speed, and we can double tap on that.
Pop-up window. Decrease reading speed.
And we can decrease
reading speed 1x. Increase reading speed.
And we can increase
reading speed 1.25x.
Visual impairities
and I'm just going to do the back gesture.
Reading mode.
And pause again.
Play.
While it's reading, it highlights what's being read or what has already been read in blue, or it could also change depending on your phone's color theme. Then we'll go check out the
text size
button. If we double tap on there,
pop-up window, decrease.
We can decrease
text size decreased.
The font size
increase text size,
and we can double tap to increase
text size increased.
Now, for me, as somebody who uses a screen magnifier and magnification, it's this like little pop-up window is not super accessible for me. It's just too small, and it's hard to see the little pop-up as opposed to the background. So I hope that Google kind of changes this UI. It's just not that easy for me to see. But I'm going to back out of there, and we'll look at the settings. Double tap there.
Settings. Hide settings. Close.
So there's two tabs here, display and audio. First, we'll go look at display.
Audio. Decrease text size.
You can decrease, increase. So this is an alternative way to decrease and increase text size.
Sans serif for font style.
So you can choose from different fonts.
Sans serif. Serif. Ebgarama. Poppins. Lexan. Comic Nui.
So there's about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different fonts to choose from. This drop-down menu is kind of cut off, and hopefully Google can fix that as well. Again, this is very new, so hopefully they'll be able to continue developing this app. Let's see what else we've got here.
Sans serif. Setting. Checked. Small line spacing.
There's...
Not checked. Large line spacing.
Okay, you can control the different line spacing.
Not checked. Largest line spacing. Not checked. Bold text.
You can make the text bold. Selected. And here system there's dark. Different themes to
not
choose
selected.
From.
System light. Not selected. High contrast dark. Not selected. Low contrast. Not selected. Dyslexic friendly. Not selected. Low contrast light. Not selected. Low contrast dark. Use system theme.
Okay.
Matches your device's lighter. Offer use system theme.
Okay.
Underline current text.
You can also have it underline the current text. I'll go ahead and select that.
On.
And we can look at that in a minute, and then we can go back.
Send feedback. Hide settings. Close. Selected. Audio.
And now we'll look under audio.
Audio. Reading speed.
We can change reading speed from here.
Decrease reading. Reading speed 1. Increase reading speed. Reading voice.
And then we have some different reading voices.
English, United States. 1 for reading voice.
When you double tap on that drop down, you can choose from a few, I think 4 different United States voices, and... visually, it's cut off, and again, I hope Google's able to fix that text and maybe go to the next line and have each list item be 2 lines so everybody can see if it's voice 1, 2, 3, or 4, and this is probably because my display size is largest, and so is my font size. Visually, all it says is English, United Stat, and it doesn't tell you, like, if it's voice 1, 2, 3, whatever, which... unfortunately happens a lot, but I wish Google could work with accessibility a little bit more on this front. So I'm just going to keep English voice 1. You can experiment which one you like the best.
Tutorial.
And there's a tutorial.
Send feedback.
And send feedback. So the tutorial is just the same tutorial that we went through just a few minutes ago. And so I'm just going to back out of this.
Reading mode. Settings.
And I'll just...
play.
I'll quickly show you that little highlight.
Pause.
On the screen, especially articles. The newly released app works on any device running Android.
Play.
Okay, so there's like a little pink horizontal line that goes across the whole line to kind of give you an idea of where you are and where it's reading. Unfortunately, you can't play the audio in the background like you can with other apps like At Voice Aloud Reader and Speech Central and things like that. But you also don't need to go to the share menu and find the correct app to listen to it. And you can just use a quick little gesture or button, which is something that I actually kind of really like. I wish Google would make it so that you could play it in the background while you're doing other things. That would be really helpful, I think. Again, this is a new app, so there's a few quirks with TalkBack, but it has come a long way. I've heard from the beta and everything, and hopefully Google will be able to continue developing this reading mode. I think it has so much potential, and I think this can be so helpful to myself and a lot of other people. So that's reading mode. Hopefully you can try it out and see how it works for you. Let me know in the comments what you guys think of this, and I'll be doing lots more videos on Google and technology and accessibility. So again, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and I will see you in the next video.